Anime, like a lot of media, tends to reflect the problems and feelings of the era it's made in, being somewhat of a window into the souls of many people who make it. The COVID-19 pandemic is the hardest thing a lot of the world's population has had to contend with in their entire lives, and talk about vaccines has stirred up an enormous amount of controversy within the political landscape of the current day. Lots of people, especially some very specific, literally orange people, just can't seem to understand how important and necessary the COVID vaccine really is. Thankfully, the universe's paragon of virtue and coolest place on Earth, Japan, understands this fact completely, and this sentiment has been reflected in Japanese anime for years. One thing people seem to think about vaccines is that they might harm you, but the popular anime/manga One Piece, created by Eiichiro Oda in 1997, definitively proves that they are actually good for you. The character Emporio Ivankov, introduced in the Impel Down arc, has the power of the Hormone Fruit. This lets him shoot people with FDA-approved vaccines that cure people of any possible illness. For example, he uses it to change a man into a woman. As a man myself, I constantly think about how much happier I would be and how much better my life would be if I had been born a woman. It makes me so angry, knowing I belong to the same sex as the people who have started every war, hurt every person, killed in the name of every single religion, and oppressed the opposite sex for any reason they could. I know if I was a woman, I would be such a better person automatically. Ivankov also heals Monkey D. Luffy from certain death with his vaccines, which is further evidence to their benefits. Masashi Kishimoto, creator of the popular manga Naruto, actually used the story of Naruto to combat anti-vaccine sentiment, especially the idea that it causes autism. The character Orochimaru is actually the true protagonist of Naruto for this very reason. His every act in the world is in search of immortality and knowledge, very similar goals to the brave scientists that create vaccines. He was actually shunned and criminalized for supposedly evil experiments he performed in secret on the citizens of Konoha. And at one point in his tragic escape, he intended to use his knowledge of vaccines to give himself the abilities of another ninja to make that escape slightly easier. He ended up escaping regardless and spent the next several years being victimized and discriminated against for just trying to make the world a better place. Now, in interviews through the years, Kishimoto slowly revealed that Orochimaru was actually based on Dr. Anthony Fauci, a notable member of the medical field and the current face of the effort to slow the spread of the coronavirus. With this parallel being pointed out, you notice a lot of the similarities between them that are just so obvious in hindsight. Orochimaru, like Dr. Anthony Fauci, is brave, highly intelligent, incredibly badass, and kind of sexy in all honesty. Orochimaru also did a lot of noble experimentation on unsuspecting victims in order to further his goals, just like Dr. Anthony Fauci. Allegations have come to light recently that claim that Dr. Anthony Fauci funnels money from his division of the National Institutes of Health into a lab in Tunisia that tortures and kills beagle puppies. These dogs are infected with disease-causing parasites and then allowed to develop infections before being euthanized so that their blood can be collected. There are also reports of an experiment involving live puppies having their heads locked in cages filled with sandflies to record their reactions to having their faces eaten off by these aforementioned sandflies. Experiments by the University of Georgia have also been conducted with money from the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases, which Fauci is the current director of, and a spokesperson of the university claimed that their research was for a vaccine to protect against a disease. The spokesperson did not elaborate on what disease this vaccine would combat. The University of Pittsburgh has been revealed to be conducting experiments in which they remove the scalps of aborted babies and graft them onto lab rats. The university's research has been shown to be funded by Fauci as well. Also, in a brilliant move, Fauci actually lied about the NIH funding gain-of-function research. These experiments are all things many people might find comically evil, abhorrent, overtly villainous, and insane. People might find the idea that someone who is in such a position of power, who has been telling the American populace how they should be conducting themselves for over a year, yet does such cruel things to be deeply infuriating. However, the story of Orochimaru tells us that we don't have a thing to worry about. Dr. Anthony Fauci is just about the best person we could put our trust into, and that is what anime teaches us.